Hi guys, thanks for joining me. This is Gentle Yoga Flow. So we're gonna move to our mat and we're gonna start there using a couple of props, blocks, blankets, and a strap. And again, if you don't have these, you can substitute them with a towel. The blocks can be substituted by pillows, and the blankets just to give you a little bit more cushioning for the head or the knees. All right, so let's get started. So I'm gonna move to the mat, and again, you can use this any form of way that works for you, having a support under your shoulder blades. And if it, again, this height doesn't work for you, you can always take it off, right? The reason why we have that support of the shoulder blades and the other block a little bit higher for the head, you bring your hands behind the head, you tuck your chin into your chest, so you lengthen the back of your skull. And this is really to allow you to start to open into the shoulders, into the chest, which is our main focus today. You can have the soles of the feet onto the floor, feet a little wider than your knees, and the knees knocking in, creating a little bit of a teepee. And this will help you to release any tension in the lower back, broadening there. Palms are facing up to the sky, so you can feel this opening into your chest, into your shoulders. Allow the body to soften and release. Take a nice deep breath through your nose. And a big sigh through the mouth. Letting go of tension, of stress, of drama. Again, inhaling peace and calm. And exhaling anxiety, stress, fear. Just let it wash away. Take one more deep breath in through the nose. And a huge sigh through the mouth. Allowing your body to start to settle in. Noticing the weight of your body. Noticing the blocks, the floor, the mat supporting you so you can let go completely. And the more you let go, the more support you'll find. And start to soften the muscles in your face as you start to scan down. Relaxing the cheeks, the jaw, and softening the tongue. Feel the release of the back of the throat. Shoulders relaxing, elbows supported. So you can soften all the way to your fingertips. Feeling the chest wide open, heart open. As you allow your hips to feel heavy, releasing down into the earth. Relaxing your legs, the knees, all the way down to your toes. As you find your body fully supported, relaxed, and safe, start to deepen the awareness to your breath. And taking one hand to the belly, noticing the rising and fall of the belly. Belly breath is very soothing and calming to the nervous system. And perhaps you take your other hand to your ribs. So we're going to take a two-part breath, inhaling into the belly. Lift it a little bit higher to the ribs. And exhale it down. One more time, belly and ribs, and exhale it down. Three-part breath, Durga breath. Take that hand to the top of the chest, collarbones, inhale, belly, ribs, all the way up. Flare the ribs, expand your breath. And as you exhale, top to bottom, empty it out. One more time. Breathe into the belly, the ribs. Take a little bit more sip of air all the way to the top. And a big exhale down. Just noticing now. Your breath most likely is deeper, smoother, longer. And the mind most likely quieter, calmer. So when we start to draw the awareness to the breath, in this case, we actually add the pranayama, breath control, controlling the breath. It's a great way to calm the mind. And you can use this tool of breath awareness or control the breath to help your mind to start to settle in and find a little bit more peace, a little bit more pause between your thoughts. The pause, you can take that deeper breath, react better and feel better. Whenever you need, you can come back to it. Letting your other hand rest one over the other, over your heart. And breathe in the gratitude of being here today, of taking time from your busy schedule to take care of yourself. That fill you with joy, gratitude. And setting up the intention for your practice. What is your heart's deepest longing? Breathe it in. And as you exhale, slowly start to release your arms to the side. Start to firm your feet to the floor, knees up to the sky. And as you inhale, let your fingertips reach straight up. And as you exhale, start to soften your elbows, reach your arms back. You're going to go at your own range of motion. That means it doesn't have to touch the floor. We sweep the arms along the side, inhaling forward and up. Exhale, starting to reach back, softening to the elbows, sweep the arms one more time. Three is a charm here. Inhaling forward and up. Exhale back. Let the backs of your hands rest. Feel your heart wide open like you had wings, like an angel spreading out. Inhale. As you exhale, start to close your elbows parallel to each other like a number 11. Keeping those elbows bent as you inhale, open the heart. Backs of the hands might touch the floor. Exhale, closing your elbows parallel in front of you. Take one more opening of the heart. And a big exhale. Allow your right elbow to cross in front of the left to give yourselves a hug, holding the tips of your shoulders here. Inhale, let your elbows point straight up to the sky. Exhale, perhaps the backs of your hands find each other. Eagle arms, Garudasana arms. Inhale, you can reach back. Maybe the arms will come closer to your face. As you exhale, start to pull your belly in. Elbows come in. And maybe you start to even add a little bit of a curl of the body. Inhale, release. Exhale, you open. Take a breath. Exhale, you close your elbows parallel to each other. This time it's the left in front of the right. Hugging your shoulders. Inhale, elbows start to point up like you're going to take a tight t-shirt off. Exhale, backs of your hands might find each other. Garudasana arms, eagle arms. Inhale, maybe the arms will reach back. And as you exhale, start to pull belly in, chin into chest as you curl. Inhale, release. And exhale, you open. And allow your knees to start to windshield wipe a little side to side. We're going to turn slowly over to one side so you can take those blocks out of the way. Just push them out to the side. Now, if you feel that you need a blanket under your head for extra support, you just take that blanket and slide it under. Again, it's always there for you, right? You can choose whatever feels comfortable. You pick up your right knee and then your left knee and you bring it into your chest. I'm just starting to release any tension in the lower back. Capping the knees here with your hands, start to circle your knees in one direction. Massaging that lower back. And then taking the knees the other way. Let them circle around. Drop your left foot down to the floor. Keep your right knee into your chest and holding behind the right thigh. Start to kick your right leg up and down a couple of times. Now, right away, if you feel that it's hard for you to hold behind the right thigh, you can take your strap, like extension of your hands or your towel, and hold it here, right? Hold it up there, point flex and roll your ankle, point flex and roll it the other way. And then from here, start to bend that knee. Perhaps you take that strap over, half happy baby. You start to pump that knee in and up, getting a little bit more knee, more groin. And we're gonna keep that knee bent and then start to open to the side, out and in. So now you're gonna start to feel it onto your inner leg. Your lower back is very supported here because your other foot is bent. And with your next exhale, we're gonna cross right ankle over the left thigh. This is called figure four. We're gonna bring that right knee away from you. Right away, that might already be enough sensation onto your right hip, right glutes. But if you want more, you can take your strap or your hands between the legs as you pick up your left foot and hold behind the left thigh, hands or strap. And the more you start to bring your left knee closer to your left shoulder, the more you're going to feel this under your right glute. So always adjusting for whatever you need here. Allow your body perhaps to rock a little side to side. And from this, we're going to drop the feet and the knees. Again, the knees can be stacked or can just be crossed that way as you start to find a twist. Let your right arm open to the right. Let the head perhaps look over to the right. And you can allow small movements of the neck and shoulders here to release tension on the neck and the shoulders. You start to get a nice twist to the side body. And if you want more, you bend that elbow and reach your fingertips slightly behind. Again, if that might be a little too much. So if you feel that you need to keep that hand parallel, keep it there. As the head moves, you get that really nice opening to the kidney line, the armpit. Kind of like getting a little bit more engagement of those lymph nodes that helps with your immune system. Exhale, bring yourself back to the center and then give your knees a hug and a gentle rock. Capping the knees here, you start to circle it to one side and perhaps you cap the knees and circle it the other way. Great job. And drop the right foot. Keep your left knee in and you hold behind. And again, start to kick that leg up and down. Small movements, right? So just noticing what's going on this side. So take it easy. Holding it up there, point flex the toe and roll the ankle. Point flex and roll it the other way. Again, the strap can always come behind the thigh if you need more. We're gonna bend that knee and gonna take the strap up and over. And we're gonna start to add that little pumping up and down. Knee in and you press up. In and up. Two more. Nice. Bring that knee in, hold that knee bent and start to move it in and out. So this is that half happy baby. It's a really nice release into the inner leg, to the lower back, helps to reset it. Also helps to massage your internal organs here for digestion, constipation. The next time the leg moves back in, you're gonna cross that ankle over the thigh. Let your knee move away from you. And just like you did before, staying with that right foot onto the floor, if that's already enough, onto your left glutes, or taking the strap between, under, and around. As you bring it in, give it a little squeeze, noticing the sensations here. How does this feel? Maybe a gentle rocking of the body. Rocking tends to be very soothing to the nervous system as well. And then from this, you can move it to the side. Let that knee drop. And again, you can stay in this position. It can be one knee stack on top of the other, or even that twist. And then allow your left arm to open. So again, it could be more parallel to the body as a T, or more engagement by bending the elbow and reaching it back. So again, find the one that works for you today as you breathe in and out. The head feels soft. And when you're ready, slowly head to the center, knees come back to the center, give them a hug and a gentle rock. Nicely done. We're gonna turn this to the side and all the way to the belly. So as you come to your belly, you can adjust that edge of the blanket to support your forehead. So sometimes it feels like your nose is going to smash on the floor. If you don't like to stack your hands and let your forehead be supported on your hands, you can put that blanket just to add a little bit of extra there. And just start to move your hips a little side to side. So this is starting to release some tension into the back, into the hips. We're going to start to take it a little bit more. We're going to bring our hands closer to the body, to the hips. Palm is going to face the floor. Now you're going to roll the heads of your shoulders back. Tint the fingers like little spider fingers and then squeeze your elbows a little closer together. Start to feel that your back muscle starts to engage. Your chin is going to stay down. Your nose is going to stay down. And then just soften here. So we're not lifting anything else. We're just starting to engage the back. Now focus on your right inner leg, lifting a little bit more. So your right toe is trying to plug into that back wall. And then lower your leg a little. And then just noticing how that might have lengthened that right leg. Do the same thing with the left. Feel the left inner leg lifting and guiding, the left toe trying to push back and plug into the wall. And then release. So again, it's not about how high you go, but how long you can get. So now you keep the length of your legs, tops of your feet pressing into the floor, inner legs engage. Press your fingertips, roll the heads of your shoulders up and back away, squeeze your elbows, and now engage those back muscles. Now feel the crown of the head reaching forward like a flashlight. So your gaze is staying down, your nose is staying down, and then relax. Let's try that one more time. Roll the heads of the shoulders, squeeze your elbows, and find perhaps a little bit more lift. Some of you might stay here or even move those hands closer to your low ribs and feel like your hands are going to drag back. And then release, and then slide your hands or wrists or fists under your forehead and release your hips a little bit side to side. So that can be a lot intensity onto the back, but I think you want to find a little bit more strength into the back. So we're just exercising, not about how high you can go, but how long you can get. And then from here, I'm going to take it one step ahead and start to slide our hands forward. Elbows are going to be on the mat. So if you look at your hands and your arms here, they look like a number 11. They're parallel to each other. And the heads of the shoulders, the elbows, and the wrists are in the same line. Plant the palms and feel like your elbows are going to pull into your body. Navel's engaging, tops of the feet are engaging, and feel the lift a little bit more, but relax your head and maybe soften it a little side to side. So really working into those back muscles to keep strong. Keep opening the chest, and as you exhale, soften, bring the hands back down at the head. Rest again. This is called crocodile. And then you just let your hips move maybe a little side to side to release any tension. If it feels good, you can take your feet up and do a little sway like a cattail side to side. Sometimes that feels really good. And then release. Let your hands come closer to your body again. And you start to slide it closer to your low ribs. And then eventually you push yourself up to a tabletop position. Walk your knees under your hips. Have your hands right under your shoulders. Now from here, try not to dump into that lower back. So this is what usually causes lower back issues. So pull belly in. So again, you're going to feel that your core engagement. So your spine is long. Your chest is still opening. And your tail is dropping a little bit. So it's a little cat tail, but open chest like a cow. So staying here, start to find that stability, relax the head, and now allow yourself to move a little bit more into the spine. And maybe a little sway of the hips, maybe moving the head. So you start to move in a way that feels organic and good for your body. Maybe taking both hands over to the right as you move your hips a little bit more to the left. And then come back to the center, let the hands slide to the other side, push, drop the hips, maybe sway. Just noticing the sensations here, right? There's no right or wrong. And then you bring your hands back to the center once again. And find that neutral spine. Navel pulling in, heart opening, and the gate of your arms until slightly dropping. And then sliding that left leg back, start to pump that heel. Start to feel the connection to the back of the foot, the ankles. This is a good one for plantar fasciitis, arthritis. Hold that left hand right under your shoulder and taking your right arm up to the sky. Exhale, lower it in and down. Take that hand now forward, like you're gonna shake somebody's hand. And as you exhale, maybe you lift the other leg back. So try not to dump into the back, pull belly in. So maybe the foot is still closer to the floor. That's okay. Exhale, elbows and knees will come closer together. Inhale, you reach. Maybe you can open your elbow to the side, the knee to the side, like a little fire hydrant. Inhale, open. Exhale to the side. Drop your left hand, your right hand, and then taking your left leg out, drop it down. Moving your hips a little bit back and forth. Start to notice the sensations on your inner leg here. Breathe in, breathe out. Now you're gonna stay with your left hand where it is. So I'm on my fist here because my wrist has been have a little bit of an injury. So again, you can always stay on your fist, but if you like, you can plant the palm as well. Take your right arm up to the sky, inhale. And as you exhale, thread the needle, slide that shoulder under. So now you're twisting into your back. Get a little bit more movement there, a little bit more opening. And you can tint your left fingertips in front of your face. Some of you might even take the arm up and wrap it behind the back. You can always have a pillow or a blanket under your head or your shoulder. As you exhale, slowly slide it from under. And bring that hand back in. Bring your knees back in. And from here, slowly bring your hips all the way back. Finding a little bit of a child's pose, you can always put a blanket or a pillow or a block under the forehead. Allow the body to sway, perhaps a little side to side. And then feeling those hands dragging in, pulling yourself back into your tabletop. Few cat and cow Koreas here, moving with your breath. Find that way that flows naturally. And then you come into that center. We're gonna do the same thing on this side. So when you're ready, start to slide your right toes back. And you start to pump that heel, that ankle. You feel that sensation, right? Bottom of the foot, calves. Now staying onto your right hand, start to take your left arm out to the side. Maybe it opens and then it brings it back in. Inhale, reach it forward. Like you're gonna shake somebody's hand here, feel that reach. And maybe you pick up the back foot. Again, pull belly in, don't let it drop. Exhale, elbows and knees together. So this is core work as well. Inhale, you reach. Exhale, maybe you take your elbow to the side just for fun. Again, it might not get there, right? And you can bend under or side. If you have it to the side, extend that leg out. And move your hips back and forth. So you're starting to feel a little bit more on your inner leg. Just like we did on the other side, take that right hand to the floor and let your left arm reach up. We're gonna thread the needle, slide the back of that left hand down, reaching across so the side of the head can stay on the floor. And then maybe you can take your right arm up or even wrap it behind your back, right? So you're trying to feel the opening of that shoulder. Main focus today is that shoulder opening. Take one more breath in. And as you exhale, release, bring that hand down and then slowly slide it from under and slide that foot back. Inhaling and exhaling, maybe start to move back. Let your arms reach all the way up. So you're coming into a kneeling salutation. Let your arms lift up, raise up. And as you exhale, bring your hands to your heart. Beautiful. So we're gonna locate where those two blocks are. We're gonna use this for our next flow. So having those blocks maybe slightly ahead, you're gonna step your left foot forward. Now, again, if you need padding under your knees, you can put that blanket under. So I have actually a carpet here. So today I'm actually very soft where I am. And take your hands up to your front thigh and just start to feel a little deep and sensation onto that right quadriceps. You can take your arms up if you like. And as you exhale, find a little bit pulling those like cactus arms. You pull your elbows like you're pulling a bungee cord. And then you release. Circle those arms again, inhaling, reaching forward and up. Exhale, start to pull like into a cactus. Start to squeeze those back muscles. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Now, can you clasp your hands here behind? Maybe you can't, and that's where the strap comes in, right? So you can always hold onto a strap. Open the heart. And as you exhale, you start to bow. Maybe those arms will go a little bit higher, strap or no strap. And as you exhale, release. You're gonna keep your right hand onto the floor or onto the block and inhale, let your left arm open, coming into a lunge twist. Exhale, release that hand all the way down. As you find your blocks or the floor, now you're gonna press into that left heel, push your hips back, and you start to get a little bent into that hips pushing back, left hip. Keep that knee soft, getting a little bit more into your hamstrings. Bend into the knee, inhale, let the chest move forward and through. Exhale, press into that heel, push your hips back. One more time, inhale, forward and through. And as you exhale, we're gonna slide that foot back, knee comes down. Inhale, let your arms reach all the way up. And exhale, hands to your heart. Finding those blocks, step the right foot forward. Now you adjust the blocks here, fingertips come up. Draw that tail down, navel pulls in, so you start to feel a deeper and opening sensation onto your left quadriceps. Maybe you stay with the hand supporting. Maybe you start to take your arms up. Exhale, start to pull your elbows back. Again, like you're pulling that bungee cord. Feel that lifting of the sternum, not dumping in the back, but lifting and opening up here. And exhale, release. Circle it again, inhale, lift. Exhale, start to pull. Last time through. Now again, if you need a strap, you can use that strap. When you exhale, you pull it back, and then grabbing the strap or your fingers, roll the head to the shoulders up, open the heart. And as we exhale, we bow forwards like a version of humble warrior. You soften and then you release your left hand. It can be to the floor or to a block. And you roll it out and you open that arm up. Your left hand is like it's opening a jar and it's twisting. And next time it finds down, we're gonna push into that right heel. Right hip pushes back, knee is soft, you start to fold. Blocks are like extension of your hands here. As you inhale, you find a little bit more lift of the heart, more opening into the hips. Exhale. More opening into the hamstrings. As you fold, you soften. Be careful with your lower back. Be careful with your hamstring. As you inhale, you come up. And as you exhale, you're gonna slide that knee back. Inhale, allow both arms to come up to the sky. And with your next exhale, hands to your heart into your kneeling salutation. Locate your two blocks. And we're gonna start to step forward. So shift the weight to one foot. Tuck the back toes and shift it to the other. And then allowing yourself to keep that spine nice and long, maybe moving your hands to your thighs. And then allowing the core to engage to bring yourself all the way up. Roll the heads of the shoulders back. Inhaling, allow your arms to reach up. And exhale, hands to your heart. So we're gonna locate that strap. Now again, if you need to come closer to a wall for support, or if you want to do this part seated, you can always do this. So this is to start to open again a little bit more into the chest. So you're going to take your strap, and my strap is pretty long, so I have it doubled here. So you're going to soften your elbows, and as you inhale, you're going to reach up. So again, try not to lock the knees and drop into the back, but draw the navel in, drop the tail, knee is slightly bent. So you stack here. Arms again can be ahead or it can be a little bit above. It's your choice. So inhale here, keeping your feet a little wider to support your balance. And as you exhale, you can reach to one side, getting a nice side body stretch. Inhale, come back to the center. And exhale to the other side. Notice that the elbows don't move and you have a little bit of tension in that strap. And then exhale, release. Roll the heads of the shoulders back. Let's try that one more time. Inhale, lift, side body opening. Exhale, this time you're gonna pull a little bit more with your right, the bottom hand. So the left hand comes almost behind. Inhale, come back to the center. Allow both hands to stay equal. And then as you exhale, you're gonna tip it to the other side. Now start to pull the bottom hand, the left, and you start to bend the right elbow. It's like you're flossing here. I call this the shoulder floss. Inhale, come back to the center. And exhale, release. And roll the heads of the shoulders back. All right. So again, if you need water or move closer to a wall, you can. The next one, we're going to open a little bit more. Again, continue to open the heads of the shoulders. And we're going to take the strap behind. So having the widest part of your hips, have your hands facing forward, your thumbs out like you're hitchhiking, right? And you roll the heads of the shoulders. You keep your elbows bent and you start to pull that strap apart. So if you have a little issue with, you know, balance, you can spread your feet a little wider here and even let your tailbone stay a little closer to the wall. Just be careful that when you lift your arms, not to bump into that wall, right? So you can soften the knees and you can start to bend here and you're going to start to pull that strap apart. And you're going to go to any way that feels comfortable for you. The elbows can still be bent and you're still pulling it apart. Some of you might be able to go a little deeper with the knees bent, spine is flat. And some of you might even be able to drop it a little bit more. Right? So again, this can be very different for everyone. Just making sure that you don't go too far down if that's an issue for you. Or maybe go all the way further, right? Again, it's everybody's different. And then slow and control, you're going to roll yourself up. Come up slow so you don't get dizzy. Again, this is a really big one for the shoulders and the chest. We're going to let that strap go to the side. Actually, I threw mine way far away. I can't reach it there. All right. So when you're ready, inhale, reach your arms up to the sky. Beautiful. Feel how your shoulders are open. Exhale, bring your hands to your heart. Soften your knees. You start to hinge from your hips. Bring your hands to your right thigh and slide your left foot back. And then draw your left heel in an angle, 90-degree angle. And from the support and bring yourself up, engage your core and you allow your arms to open up, finding your warrior one. And as you exhale, let that arm open out and maybe you find your warrior two. Now warrior two is a stance is a little wider than warrior one. So if you need to open it out a little bit more, that's fine. If you want to stay a little bit higher, that's okay. So just don't let the front knee pass the toes. And try not to let that knee bump in. Open it to the pinky toe side. Arms are nice and long, shoulder height. And from here, turning your palms up, inhale, press into the front heel and finding your flow. Exhale, bend. One more time, press into the heel. Inhale, peaceful warrior. Exhale, bend. And then from this, take your left hand to your hip. Turn your right palm up and reverse your warrior. Press into the front heel, reverse triangle. Keep the length of the side body. Again, if your elbow needs to bend, any scar tissue, that's absolutely fine. As you exhale, letting your right hand or forearm come to your thigh and start to roll the shoulder back. So you start to feel that your chest starts to open a little bit more. Some of you might come down to your forearm. Some of you might even sneak the back of your left hand onto your lower back to open into the shoulder. Finding your version of extended side angle. So usually we do this pose with a full extension, but to focus a little bit more on the shoulders today, and you find that revolving. Relax it out and use your core and the back arm to bring yourself up. And then as you exhale, we're going to bring our hands back to the blocks or to the thighs to step the other foot all the way forward. Press into your feet. And as you inhale, let your arms reach up. And as you exhale, let the hands come behind your back or your strap, roll the shoulders, open your heart, inhale. I'm just going to turn it around so I don't turn my back to you. And as you exhale, you're going to start to soften the knees, bend, release your hands to your left thigh and slide your right foot back. Shimmy that left foot a little bit more to the left. And the back foot is in an angle here. And when you feel ready, engage the core, climb your body up into your warrior one. And as you exhale, let that arm open out, warrior two. And maybe you shimmy that foot a little bit more. Relax the shoulders here by turning the palms up. Press into the front heel, inhale, reach up, lift up. Exhale, bend. Don't let that knee flop in. Inhale, reach up. So you don't torque your knee, keep it healthy, exhale. Now your right hand comes to your hip, left palm goes up, and it's gonna sweep up, up, and back as you press into the front heel, inhale. And as you exhale, keep that length into the side body as you bring that hand or forearm to the thigh. And you start to find revolving and opening into your right shoulder. Maybe the back of that right hand slides behind, right? So it doesn't matter how far you're going, you're just focusing and opening. Where else can you soften? So again, instead of the arm reaching out, it's opening back. So you can choose variations. And then when you feel ready, core engagement, you bring yourself back up. And as you exhale, slowly pinwheel your hands back. And you find yourself back onto the front. Inhale, allowing your arms to reach. And the exhale, allowing the hands to come back to the heart. And just connecting with your breath. And then slowly softening those arms down. As we prepare for one more balance pose. Now again, you can stay closer to a wall if you need. We're gonna move into crescent moon. So if you're coming closer to a wall, you don't actually need that block as much, only if you're trying to shift the weight from one side to the other. As if you come to the wall next to you, I pretend that my wall is next to me here. Soften your knees a little bit. And from this, you're gonna take the top, your left arm and start to reach over your head. So the elbow can be bent. And now you move your right hand about hip height. So there's this little space between the wall, right? So imagine there's a line here, the wall and up. So if you push into the bottom and you reach with the top, and then can you find a little bit more opening of the heart, the chest? Can you feel that opening through the side? So you're kind of pushing your hips away as you reach up and over. Press into that big toe mound of that left foot. And then slowly release. Right? So this can be pretty big. And you're really shifting the weight more from one side to the other. So it becomes like more of that weight balancing. And now you can take it to the other side soft. And now imagine again, you can imagine that this is my line, my imaginary wall where I'm pushing my hand into it. And my other arm is going to reach up and over. And I push. And my hips start to move away. And my top arm is trying to reach the wall. You press into that big toe mound. Again, if you want to shift the weight, you can even take the toes to the side a little bit or even cross it behind, right? So anytime you make your stance narrow, it's going to make it a little bit more tricky to balance, right? And then we bring it back to the center and release and roll your shoulders up and back. Great job. So we're going to come to the front edge of your mat, wherever the front is for you. And inhale, let your arms reach up. We're going to come down to the mat. As we exhale, soften hands to the thighs, fingertips to the blocks or the floor as you step one foot and then the other back. And then allowing the hands to come down, the hips to follow, and finding yourself all the way to your seat. You might have a blanket or your blocks to sit on, wherever feels more comfortable for you. So I'm just taking the blanket here. And as I find my seat, I can cross my legs. So maybe crossing the legs feels uncomfortable on your hips. So you can always open your legs out. Now taking that strap, we're going to play with that again. So you're going to take your strap to your left hand. I'm going to mirror you here. And you're going to bend that elbow and you're going to let that strap come behind you. And you take your right hand and kind of guiding that elbow a little bit up and back and close to you. And then you take your right arm out, turn your right thumb down, and the back of the hand slides to your back. And you might find that edge of the strap. This is called Gomukhasana, cow face. You inhale, lift your heart. And as you exhale, chin into chest, slightly hinging a little bit more. Noticing how that can get a little deeper. And then slowly release, let it go. And as you do, find a gentle twist over to the left. Inhale, lift the spine. Exhale, revolve. Nicely done. Now, noticing what shin is in front of you, you're just going to bring your hands behind you, extend your legs, give a little shake, and then switch. Now, again, if that doesn't feel right, just let it go, right? There's always room for exploration of changing, finding what works for you. So you're going to take the strap now on your right hand as you take it out, and you start to take that arm behind you. And then your left hand can come here to guide that elbow a little closer in and up higher, so maybe the hand will drop further back. You take your left arm out, thumb down, and the back of that left hand starts to slide to your lower back. Maybe it stays on the lower back, or maybe it climbs a little bit higher to hold the strap tighter. Take a nice deep breath in. And with your next exhale, maybe a gentle fold. You're just going as far as you're comfortable. As you exhale, gently release, bring yourself back down. Excellent work. I'm going to take that out to the side. And today we're going to finish with Stonehenge, which is one of my favorite things. You take the two blocks. So I'm turning it to the front so you can see. And then you use your blanket or blankets, depending if you have one or two or more. And you can put it on top. So you're going to put your shins on top of that. So this is the view from the front, and on your mat is that when you come to your mat, you're going to come with your hips close by, that when you release, you're going to bring your knees into your chest, give it a little bit of a hug, capping your knees here, circle your knees to one side, and then the other. Perhaps letting the holding behind the knees or the shins, or variation of happy baby. If you have more flexibility to hold onto the feet without taking the shoulders off the floor, you can do that. But if your shoulders are coming off the floor, you're hugging too much, hold just behind the shin, and that should be enough. And with your next exhale, you allow one leg and then the other to extend forward. Let your arms release. You're just starting to feel the reverse of the flow and the supported inversion. Legs a little bit higher. Releasing the flow into the belly. And if you prefer to have your legs up against the wall in Viparita Karani, you can always do that as well. The muscles in your face are relaxing. The cheeks and the jaw and the tongue. The arms are relaxed. The heart is light and the belly is soft. Just allowing your body to totally release and let go. If you're happy where you are, stay where you are. You're in the comfort and safety of your home. But if you feel like moving, start to wiggle the fingers and the toes, adding the wrists and the ankles. Take your time. Maybe that gentle rock of the body as your knees come into your chest. And rolling to the side that feels more comfortable for you so you can use your hands to come up to your seat. And allowing the head to rest over the heart and the heart to rest over the hips. Everything is stacked up nicely so it's easier to hold without too much effort. And just feeling the heart wide open as you bring the right and the left hand one over the other over your heart. Feeling for all the hard work into your practice. And being thankful as we bow the head to the heart. Surrendering the mind to the divine in the heart. Let your heart guide you. Namaste. The light in me bows to the light in you. Thank you so much for letting me guide you today. If you have any questions, doubts, you can always send me an email. Be well. Thank you.